Hey, yo, what the?
What is going on, you beautiful people? This is EK. I also go by Ethan.
What's good? I'm Isaiah. You could call me Icy.
Hey, if you guys are trying to get lyrical, you guys came to the right place.
We're the lyrical Asians, baby.
The president of Toronto, Canada.
Kawhi?
Not Kawhi.
Oh, shit.
Has dropped a single dissing someone with a size 17. I think Drake's obsessed with some toes, bro, or something. But we got
Anita Max win.
We got Push-Ups by Drake.
Bro, I'll be honest, I didn't think he was gonna actually release this on streaming platforms.
I think he for sure like leaked it first, and then he let everybody put their opinion on it, and then decided to just drop it on streaming.
I think it's crazy that every rapper is coming for each other's heads now, bro.
That's true.
The music industry is not safe.
Mm-mm. Hey, right off the top with Push-Ups, though.
Yeah.
Bro, that's like a reference towards Kendrick, because Kendrick's Finsta, he'd be going around Compton at like random parks and just does Push-Ups.
Oh, shit. I think I've actually seen that video. He was at some spot.
Yeah. So that's already like, damn, that's already a shot.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro, what you think about the whole war that's going on?
I think it's good for the culture.
Yeah?
Because everyone is talking about it, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think that people want to see other rappers bringing up other rappers and making diss tracks.
Yeah, I mean, dude, I thought they got past that, kind of like beefing and dropping diss tracks with each other.
Nah, bro.
But I guess not.
Because I think even Kanye hopped on a podcast and dropped a remix to Like That. I think dissing Drake and a bunch of other people too.
Yeah, we need to tap into that one too. But that man Kanye, bro, of course he wants to. I feel like there's rap, like Drake and Kendrick, this beef is authentic, yeah. But other rappers like Rick Ross.
I think Rick Ross is just trolling.
Yeah, he's just in it to get the hype right now.
I mean, I don't blame him, bro. I think this is a good time to just. Well, I mean, he had to say something, bro. I'm pretty sure he hopped in the studio like right after he heard the
He dropped it in like 2 hours, bro.
Right after Drake's diss, bro. No, Drake is definitely a petty ass dude, because he dropped
what's up?
Another diss track, but he had the AI voices of Snoop Dogg and Tupac.
Yeah, I don't know about that one.
Yeah, I think that was.
I haven't heard the actual song, but
I haven't either.
No, using the whole like AI thing, I think that's just
another level.
Of yeah. You didn't need to do that. If you, on Kendrick's To Pimp a Butterfly album, the last song called Mortal Man, it's a song where he's kind of like talking to Tupac, but they're using like lines of Tupac's like old movies, I think. So, I mean, maybe that was kind of like a shot towards that, but I don't know. I think he went a little too far using AI.
Yeah. What's your thoughts on this whole rap civil war that's going on? Do you think it's good?
Yeah, it's good for us, like, entertainment-wise, but, dude, I hope it's just not, like, covering up something big.
It probably is. Because
everyone's just dropping disses on each other.
Yeah.
Like, I think Quavo and Chris Brown, they both dropped a diss track on each other.
Yeah, well, I think Chris Brown out-rapped him.
Oh, really?
From what I've heard.
Damn, he got bodied by a singing dude. But, hey, let's take a look back at, like, Drake's disses, though.
Yep.
So starting off with back-to-back freestyle, obviously he murked Meek Mill.
Yeah, I didn't even think Meek Mill would come back from that or even have a rap career.
Nah, bro, to fix that, he had to apologize, or like they met up and dropped that one song.
Oh, yeah.
What is it called? I know it's like hella popular, but.
Yeah, I don't remember that. I'm not good with names, bro.
Meek had no choice but to collab with Drake, like just to get his rep back up.
But I think also too, like Drake, I feel like he does put like, whenever he has a feature on, like with Rick Ross, I feel like they're a pretty good duo and they make some pretty good hits.
Yeah, see.
So I don't know what, I don't think they're actually going against each other.
Mm-mm.
I think it's just all a cash grab.
Yeah. When Pusha T dropped those, Story of Added On. Who do you think won that beef?
Not Pusha.
What?
Bro, I don't know, bro. I think he kind of fell off.
Pusha T, are you serious?
Yeah.
I think Pusha T killed Drake. Yeah, I don't know, bro.
That's why Drake couldn't even respond to that.
Like, I'm hoping that when Kendrick drops, I hope it's not like that song, because the story of Adon literally like fucked with Drake's mental health, the people that are dying around him. Dude, made Drake and turned into a good dad. If without Pusha, we probably wouldn't even know Adonis lived.
All right, you do have a point.
So I hope with this, like, when Kendrick drops, I hope it's more of like a debacle, I guess. Like, they both are going at each other instead of like a one way.
I feel like he doesn't even need to drop anything though.
Who, Kendrick?
Kendrick.
I don't know, bro.
Because I feel like he kind of killed it on like that.
That's the thing. I don't know if he will drop the diss track soon, because Like That is still number one.
Yeah, there's no need to, bro. Everyone's still talking about it too.
So yeah, but dude, before we even listen to this this song, I just want to say RIP to J. Cole.
So I'm so proud of that project, except for one part. It's one part of that shit that make me feel like, man, that's the lamest shit I ever did in my fucking life, right?
Man, that's the lamest shit I ever did.
Yeah.
The only soldier that died in round one.
He didn't even make it past round one, bro. Jesus. And then to apologize, I'm pretty sure that pissed Drake off too.
Yeah, definitely.
Because they literally just had a tour together. Yeah. Pretty sure they're nice. Like this, they're cool.
Mm-hmm.
And Drake was hoping that J. Cole would side with him, but hey, the music industry is fake, bro. I think if I was a rapper, I wouldn't even be doing collabs with other rappers, just because stuff like this could pop up.
Yeah.
Could be used against you.
I think that's why Kendrick and Drake only have the Poetic Justice song. That's their only collab. Because I think before, Drake has said it like, oh, I'm the one that like made Kendrick popular because of that song.
I haven't heard that.
So that's true. That's a good way to look at it.
Round one, fight.
Hey, I could never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for man. I'm out of Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't never take no chain off of us. How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man's on? This be Bart with the bite, nigga, what's up? I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Extortion, baby, whole career, you been shook up. This top told you drop and give me 50 likes of push-ups. Cool, your last one brick, you really not on shit. Ooh. They make excuses for you cause they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract cause we gotta see the split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty.
Ooh.
Then we need a verse for the Swifties.
Hey, that was a good song,
top say
bro.
Drop, you better drop and give them 50.
Yeah.
Next week, pipe down. You ain't in no big three. SZA got you wiped down. Travis got you wiped down. Savage got you wiped down.
Ooh, I don't know about that
like
one.
Like a label, boy, you in a scope right now. And you gon' feel the aftermath of what I write down. I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. Just to add this talk with your ass, I had to hike down. Big different swing, Mike then and Mike now. What the fuck is this, a 20v1, nigga?
Yeah, okay, he addresses it. Let's go.
Son, nigga. Get more love in the city that you from, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some calls, nigga. Yeah, I'm the sixth guy, I'm the front runner. Y'all nigga man.
I mean, that's really true, bro. You do be making them drums.
Six and you boys ain't even come from it. And when you boys got rich, you had to run from it. Cash blowing, able bread out here tricking. Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas.
Ooh.
Jazz whips, chains, wicked, wicked, wicked.
Oh,
you tripping, Drizzy tripping there. Probably got
the future.
Got him done, boy. Don't make me at the chipping there. Rolling loud stage, I would turn. That was slick as hell. Shit'll probably change if it's been start to kiss and tell. Hugs and kisses, man. Don't tell me about no switches. I'll be rocking every fucking chain I own next busy. Ayy, I'll be with some bodyguards like Whitney. Top say, drop your little midget ass. Better fucking.
Oh my god, bro. You just name dropped Kendrick's wife.
Drop and give me.
I ain't just name drop some midgets, bro. They don't even like to call midgets.
Really got me out here rapping what I'm living. I might take it latest girl a cuff like I'm Ricky. Can't believe he jumping in his nigga turning 50. Every song that made it on a chart he got from Jizzy. Spin
that little check, you gotta stay about my business. Nigga, shout out to the hooper that be busting out the gritty. We know why you mad, nigga, I ain't even tripping. All that little heartbroken Twitter shit for bitches. This for all the top dogs, drop and give me 50, drop, drop. In that fucking song, y'all got to not start to beef with us. This shit been brewing in a pot, now I'm heating up. I don't care what Cole think, that dot shit was weak as fuck. Champagne tripping, he is not fucking easing up. Nigga calling top to see if top wanna piece it up. Top wanna piece it up, top wanna piece it up. Nah, pussy, now you on your own when you speaking up. You don't roll beat to this, you not fucking beeping up. Begging cops or not, boy, you not fucking beating us. Numbers wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking creeping up.
My money names. Wise,
I'm out of here, you not fucking sneaking up. Cornball, your show. Money, merch, money, feed us. I'ma let you niggas work it out because I've seen enough. This ain't even everything I know, don't wait to demon up. This ain't even everything I know, don't wait to demon up. Drop and give me 50, all you fuck niggas teaming up. What platform you smoking on, Kendrick?
Oh.
Yeah, drop, 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 drop. Drop a 50 bag for the mob in a spot. Drop a 50 bag, 29 for the god. Really, really trying to keep it PG.
Okay.
PG.
I don't know about that last part. Future. When he mentioned Wicked. Well, yeah, obviously Kendrick's in here. We know that already. He mentioned his wife.
Fucking Metro.
Metro 2. Go and make some drums.
The Weeknd.
21 Savage. Travis and SZA. I don't think 21 Savage wiped out Kendrick when he said that.
Nah.
Rick Ross.
Yeah.
I think that's it, huh?
I think so. And of course, Top Dog. Top.
Yeah. He dissed all of TDE, huh?
Pretty much. Yeah.
I thought him and SZA were cool, bro. What the hell?
No, I don't think he dissed SZA. I think he was just saying that, like, they're better. They're all better than Kendrick.
Well, but when he mentions Top Dog, though.
Oh, not the Top. I think they're just making fun of Top, the owner of the label.
I thought he was name dropping like TDE, bro. I was like, damn, it's kind of dirty.
Damn, right off the bat though, where the fuck was his energy on For All the Dogs? This is what I was kind of like expecting from that album.
Yeah, a lot of people didn't really like For All the Dogs.
I mean,
he got a lot of shit for that.
She was ass.
It was.
But dude, he sounds motivated and aggressive.
He even said that
hungry, bro.
He even said that he knows more.
Yeah.
And I'm kind of curious on what else he knows.
I think, yeah, we'll have to see, bro. We'll have to see once Kendrick officially drops.
And then you think Drake will drop right after that?
Probably. I think
this kind of really similar with the Kanye Donda and when he dropped what's the one with the pregnant emoji ladies? What's the name of that album? Certified Lover Boy?
Certified Lover Boy, yep.
Right when Kanye dropped Donda, he dropped Certified Lover Boy.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if he'll do that with Kendrick, if he ever drops.
I mean, dude, yeah, Drake sounds hella angry, so I could see him, like, just, swinging his toes in the air, like, waiting for Kendrick to drop. Sheesh, bro. I like how he mentioned fucking the 20v1. That's funny.
It really is like that. Even on his story too, he posted like a photo of him in the middle. I forgot what movie it was from, and then a bunch of dudes surrounding him with like swords.
Oh, Kill Bill?
Kill Bill.
Yeah, that's kind of fire.
But yeah, I don't think Metro can't really. What is Metro gonna do?
I hope Metro just makes drums. Just to troll Drake. Just post a video of him making drums. I think Drake, he sent a group of what's it called, drummers to a strip club in Atlanta. And so they're just playing the drums outside.
Bro, that's some Drake shit, bro. That's some Drake shit. But yeah, even when he mentioned Cole, too.
I think that was going through everyone's head.
Yeah.
That was literally, yeah, that was weak. I like how he pointed that out, too. This is the part of our show that we're about to get lyrical. Shit, I do like how he mentioned the Maroon 5 need a verse. You better make it witty.
Yeah.
Because people, like, they be claiming that Kendrick is, like, only the master of rap. But then he's also, you know, doing these little verses outside of rap. But I don't get it, though, because Drake had, like, a commercial where he was dancing to Bad Blood.
Because, baby, now we got bad blood. You know it used to be mad love. So take a look what you've done. Because, baby, now we got bad
serious?
Yes.
That's the one with Taylor Swift and Kendrick?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
It was like a Pepsi commercial, bro.
That's crazy. Okay, so you know when they did that, there was that little voice in the background? I guess that was DJ Academics.
Oh. Who's top five you smoking on?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Academics is Drake's number one dick rider, bro.
Yeah.
Okay, dude. I'd be with some bodyguards like Whitney. Have you seen the movie Bodyguard with Whitney Houston?
Nah, bro.
Pretty much she falls in love with the bodyguard. So he's saying that he's the bodyguard to Kendrick's wife. That is insane. That's a crazy double entendre.
Okay. So that's your first favorite bar then?
Yeah, I think that is. Yeah, called Kendrick a midget.
Yeah, not only is he dissing the midgets, but he's also dissing Kendrick. Oh, yeah, my first favorite bar is when he says, Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums.
Yeah, that's funny.
Because it's literally like, Metro can't really respond to that other than making drums.
Yeah.
Which would prove his point.
Metro's gonna drop his first rap song.
At this song.
I think my second bar is the one about the weekend. Shit we do for bitches, he doing for ninjas. That's like jets, whips, chains, wicked, wicked, wicked. That's a shot at both Future and The Weeknd.
With literally like two lines, two or three lines. Yeah, the one where he mentions, I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. Just to have this talk with your ass, I had to hike down.
Yeah, that's crazy.
It's a good bar, but I mean, Kendrick's up on that Mount Rushmore, bro.
Yeah, like, for sure.
Drake's not really hiking down.
Hey, when he says, I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up, I could just imagine Metro and Future just like having a Drake portrait that they look up to.
No, when he mentioned your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for Nan. I just thought that was interesting because I think he does have a lot of like, Drake has a lot of number one songs with featured artists like Ross and Future. So I could see where that could be a good claim.
Yeah.
But against Kendrick though, I don't think that.
Nah, Kendrick could sell out worldwide. Yeah. So you know how in Like That where Kendrick was like, Prince outlived my check?
Yeah.
Drake's response to that, what's a prince to a king? He is son. That's a good like clap back.
That is.
I think that'll be my third favorite one. Metro shut your ass up and make some drums.
Yeah,
that shit's comedy.
That's as good as it gets, bro. Like it's a simple line, but it gets you. Everyone gets the point.
Yeah, like I like how he stopped the beat too, just to say that. Yeah. That's just funny. Jeez, there's a lot of bars. Yeah, like I said, I like how Drake was aggressive.
Yeah.
He actually sounds hungry. He didn't need to add that. I'm gonna keep it PG.
Yeah. I don't know about that part, but I think it was a good diss, a good response to Kendrick.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, I don't know if Kendrick's gonna actually respond back, though.
Yeah, people are, like, spamming him, telling him to drop, but it took Drake 3 weeks to drop this. Like, it's only been a few days for Kendrick.
Yeah, I mean, he knows what's going on. He just ain't saying anything because he doesn't need to.
Pretty much. So with the end of round one, who do you think wins?
Round one?
Round one.
Shit, I think it's decided by TKO. Kendrick's little ass knocks out Drake. Like, Drake has some good bars against other people. But when it came to, like, directly to Kendrick, there were some good ones.
Mm-hmm.
But there are also ones that were kind of a little questionable. Like, not really,
I think it's fair, though, that he kind of, like, took some time to, like, call out everybody that dissed him on that Metro Future album.
I mean, he has to.
Like. Yeah, like, he can't just drop it towards Kendrick while everyone else is talking mad shit about him.
The whole industry, basically.
So I get it.
Yeah.
But I think with that, because of that, though, I think, I don't even like, I fucking, this pissed me off, because I, obviously, I love Kendrick, but I think this diss track was hard, bro.
Yeah.
I think Drake won round one.
Okay. Damn.
So I think
I'm kind of surprised.
Yeah, we're gonna have to, cause I mean, Like That, it's just a Kendrick verse.
Yeah, it is, but
it was a lot though within that verse, but
I mean, even Kendrick dissing For All the Dogs too was crazy.
Mm-hmm.
But I like that diss because that album was.
Not for all the dogs.
It
belonged in the cemetery. Fucking pet cemetery.
I wonder who you guys think won this this diss so far. There's definitely going to be some more coming out. Y'all better stay tuned.
Let us know in the comments what you think about this video and the fucking disses, bruh.
Yeah.
Whose side are you on?
Better choose wisely.
You could always be on our side, though. Lyrical Asians.
I'm doing it again.
Subscribe, baby.